The 15-kilometer road that connects Kalaki district to Aleptong district has one of its bridges broken and culverts washed away. The road has now been closed since it is a danger to people's lives.
So many of the bridges have been washed away. Consequently, following from the meeting that was held by the committee after the failed tour of the road, it was resolved that the engineer be arrested so as to extract a statement from him to aid with investigations into what could have transpired.
The committee members say they found no value for money while inspecting the roads.
Mistakes, they can be discovered early before a road can be commissioned. Right now, we cannot commission that road in the state it is, because there is no value for government money.
Man, she very poor, compromised, and people are complaining. And I would think if government is honest enough to put things right, let them come on board. I would also pray that let the anti-corruption unit come and investigate what is happening on.
Meanwhile, 7 Fort Portal city staff were today arrested by the State House Anti-Corruption Unit. They were quizzed for several hours before being detained at the Fort Portal Central Police Station. Wycliffe Mukama, the lead investigator, has identified the suspects as Kirunji Annette Pamela, the acting head of finance, Richard Arituha, the principal education officer, Musana Samuel, the senior physical planner, and David Baguma, the chairperson, Area Land Committee. The others are Bwango Jesse Smart, the district land board secretary, Peter Kugonza, and Nansubuga Sumini, both staff surveyors. The suspects are accused of abuse of office as well as conniving to sell off public land belonging to the Fort Portal city to a private person.
We are ready to spill the beans. So we feel that probably this is why these people have come. Financial mismanagement that are taking place here. And definitely, I can report it that for us, our opinion is this mismanagement emanates from the office of the town clerk.
According to investigations, Baguma, the chairperson, Area Land Committee, issued a false report that led to the sale of public land to a private individual. Investigations also point out to the fact that Arituha, the principal education officer, overpaid the school of clinical officers an excess of 44 million shillings and also sanctioned an approved capitation grant to a non-benefiting North Division. Report by Michael Onyinge and Roger Sande for the news.